The main focus of many communities trying to better control bushfires in northern Australia is protecting homes and infrastructure and reducing carbon emissions. But many Indigenous and environmental groups increasingly feel too much prevention burning is damaging biodiversity. Scientists have been carrying out a controlled burn to determine whether that's true and how to best balance the sometimes competing interests.
There aren't many people who go and stand in the middle of a bushfire on purpose, but scientists have been doing this at a study site north of Darwin for 17 years.
So we just need to synchronise our watches.
They set fire to 1 hectare plots and then time how quickly and intensely the fire burns towards a series of markers.
Even though fire is such a big deal here in the top end, we know remarkably little about how different ways of burning affects the plants and animals.
As the threat from wildfire intensifies, rural fire services, Indigenous ranger groups and pastoralists are carrying out more controlled burning to protect communities and reduce carbon emissions.
There is sort of some widespread concern in the community that there's too much fire around, and so what we can do is provide the information that can inform them on whether the extent to which that is the case.
The scientists are burning these plots behind me here every 2, 3 and 5 years, and that way they can tell the different impacts of the fire regimes on biodiversity.
Well, frequent fires and high intensity fires open up the understory and make it easier for cats to hunt small mammals.
Other plants and animals depend on either frequent or infrequent fire. The scientists have demonstrated that burning different areas within one region with different frequencies is good for biodiversity.
To make sure that you have those different ways of burning somewhere represented in the landscape so that all the plants and animals can be maintained in the broader region.
They've also proven that as well as preventing emissions from smoke, fire control also preserves carbon in fallen logs, and so ranger groups can now earn carbon credits for that too.
It's an additional source of income for land managers where there's not much other opportunities for economic development.
The project is opening the eyes of its students and land managers alike.
It's changed my opinion on a lot of fire regimes. I thought at first that fire is quite dangerous, but I've now learned that it's a part of the environment.
Jane Bardon, ABC News.